morning, Granada High School. I am Lindy Castro, and this is my co-host, Jennifer Louie, and we're here to bring you the news. Coin wars have just begun. Don't forget to drop off some coins into your third period class. The winning class will receive a free pizza party. Sabotage other classes by putting dollar bills in different buckets. Now here's Bob with question of the week. This week, he asked students, if you could be a mythical creature, what would it be?
If I could be a mystical creature, I would be the best unicorn ever.
Bigfoot or the Yeti?
I'd be a pterodactyl.
I'd be a leviathan because leviathans are awesome.
I would want to be a unicorn because, well, they're very pretty looking.
A robotic griffin.
I would make myself a catbird.
A mermaid. Because why not?
I'd be a lager because they have magical powers. I'd definitely be a minotaur.
A dragon. So I could fly and blow fire.
I would definitely be a narwhal.
Charlie Sheen.
All right, I'd like to be a phoenix because they can get on fire and that's kind of awesome, you know, to burn just forever.
I would be a Rathalos.
I like turtles.
I would be Towly.
Tigger.
I would be a Pegasus.
Gargoyle.
I'd be Mr. Mariotti.
I'd be this.
I would be Member Pig.
I would like to be Aslan because he is an awesome lion.
Thanks, Bob. You're awesome. There's a coat drive going on through the month of February. Donate your new and gently used coats to your third period class. Whichever class donates the most winter clothing items will earn donuts. Now here's Shabs with News of the Weird.
I'm Shabs with News of the Weird. First stories, a San Rafael woman's treasured gold necklace survived an incredible journey while it was accidentally flushed down the toilet. Sanitation workers found it last weekend and had it returned to the woman. A Utah school district had decided against using cougars as a mascot.
I'm Bob the Palmeiras, and this is News of the Weird.
That was great, Shabazz. Did you know this week is Spirit Week? Yesterday was Stoplight Day, today is Hat Day, tomorrow is Animal Print Day, and Friday is Blackout Day.
Hello, I'm Zero, candidate for Boinker. What does Zero stand for, you might ask? I'm just your chummy Ashukul's ordinary citizen. Like you, I dream of a warm, snuggly bed.
Cut down! The word is life. A snuggly life.
Remember inflection and have a smile.
Hello, Boinker, I'm Zero.
Oh, good, dear God.
What did I say?
I'm Zero, with the Boinker part.
Zero, turn around.
I'm Boinker.
Zero.
Hello, I'm Zero, candidate for Blanky.
Stop it!
Vote for Zero.
Vote for Zero.
Vote for Zero.
Vote for Zero.
Vote for me.
No, seriously, vote for Zero.
Vote for me! Who am I voting for?
Zero. Vote for Zero. That's the line.
Oh my God. But I was going to vote for Lily.
Hello, my name is Kaylin.
Tyler.
Elizabeth.
Monica.
Jane.
Brandy.
Sulin.
Juliet.
Jessica.
Amber.
Jet.
Alfonso.
And we are part of the Youth Advisory Board for the Alameda County Office of Education School Wellness and Safety Programs.
We are excited to announce our first annual public service announcement contest open to all middle and high school students that live or go to school in Alameda County.
If that's you and you're into video production, have a voice to be heard, or a hand for drawing, then this PSA contest is for you. And you will have a chance to win some cool prizes. This year's theme is Teens and Tweens Kick Ash.
Did you know that most teens don't smoke?
Or that not smoking saves lives, including yours?
And did you know that you can show us and all the teens and tweens around the world why they shouldn't smoke simply by entering the PSA contest?
Yep, that's right. So tap into your creative talents and tell us what you have to say about not smoking by producing a 30-second video or audio clip or submitting a poster.
Whatever category you choose, we wish you the best of luck. But more importantly, we want you to have fun with this and be as creative as you want to be.
So get started now, as the contest will end on Friday, March 30th, and we can't wait to see the artistic ways you decide to share with us why teens and tweens should not smoke.
Post your entry as a video response to this video,
please go to acoe.org/PSA-contest to read our contest guidelines and rules, as well as download all the required forms to enter our teens and tweens Kick Ash PSA contest.
And remember to have fun with this and be as creative as you can be.
Please like ACOE Wellness on Facebook and follow us on Twitter.
Good luck and kick ash!
I'm in the pre-med society, and here I will gain more knowledge, which means I'll probably be accepted to medical school.
Congratulations, Alicia. You worked hard for this.
Thank you.
I'm Elisa Nakuchi, and I'm a cardiovascular surgeon.
Both the boys and girls varsity soccer teams made it to NCS this season. The girls play their first round NCS game tonight at 7 o'clock p.m. at Freedom, and the boys play their game tonight at 7 o'clock at Pittsburgh High School. The girls and boys varsity basketball teams both made it to NCS as well. Granada's varsity basketball teams are having an outstanding season. Entering last night's game, the boys were 10th in NCS. Come support the varsity basketball boys with one of their biggest games, and also their last game, which is on Friday the 17th at Livermore. Show all your spirit. Now let's head over to Chloe for 60 seconds with Miss Galazan.
So, I'm here with one of our counselors, Ms. Galazan, and she's going to tell us a bit about what she does. Students say that it's much harder to drop classes these days. Is that true?
Yeah, I would say it is harder to drop classes, mainly because we're asking students to commit to the schedule that they request in the spring. And students often request a schedule, and the staff here at Granada works really hard to give students the schedule that they ordered. So we work very hard during the summer, and which doesn't make sense if everybody changes their mind in the fall. So we're just asking students to stick with the classes that they signed up for.
All right. So have you always been a counselor?
No, this is my seventh year as a counselor here at Granada. Before that, I was a teacher. I taught 6 years at elementary school, and then I taught 6 years at middle school, and then decided to come to high school.
Wow. So thank you for appearing on this week's episode of 60 Seconds.
That's all for today, Granada. We'll see you next week, and don't forget to stay beautiful. Okay.